We have already seen kind of an event handler, a content handler, content part handler specifically, previously. But now let's take a quick look at a very event handler like event handler, because that would be a good example of how events are exposed in Orchard. Because, you know, events are quite useful because you can hook into events to run your own code at specific stages in the application when something happens. That's why also content handlers are very useful, because you can just run your code when something happens with a contents item. What we'll do now is that we'll take a look at iLogin form events, so events that are exposed for the login form. And you may have guessed that all of these events will fire when something happens on the login form. This will be just one particular example, of course, but there are a lot of similar events and event handlers in Orchard. And the idea is the main point, that you can hook into events by implementing interfaces. So it's not .NET style tightly coupled events where you subscribe with your event handler, but it's very loosely coupled. You implement an interface, and then somewhere else, something else will call into that interface, and that will represent an event being executed. So let me create an event handler that will greet the user when they log in. I know, that's of course mission critical in every application, but you will understand the idea better on the simple example. We commonly put event handlers or even exposed or implemented event handlers into the events namespace. But again, this is up to you. It's good to keep to conventions, because then everybody will be familiar with your code base right away. And let's call this login greeting, for example. And at this point, I will just completely cheat and magically implement it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. And it's there. It's magic. Let me also add all the necessary namespaces here. And let's take a look at what we have. There won't be anything particularly new. Well, there is one thing new. We are implementing this iLogin form event interface, but there is a build error. And the build error is there because this interface is declared in a package that we haven't yet referenced. So let's actually do that. Now this is in an AppSections project, so we need to add a reference to orchardcore.users.abstractions. Yep, it was already there. And let's install it. And now we should get login form event soon as well. Yes. So what's happening here is that iLogin form events has three methods that you can implement or representing various events during login. And well, it's up to you what you do in these events. They are actually just events, so not a pipeline like with filters, and not even like handlers where you can modify the context objects, the currently accessed content item, but these are just events. You can do whatever you want from the codes here, but there is no specific functionality exposed. You can't like prevent the users from logging in, except that you can actually report errors on the login, which later, if the authentication pipeline does that, can indeed prevent login. So what we have implemented here is just a super simple class. When the user tries to log in, when the user actually logged in already, then we will take the notifier and display a success message. So we have already used the notifier, nothing special. What's special is that we have an event handler here. And we also need to register this event handler. So again, just as with any dependencies, we will need to register this too. And this will be needed to register it as a scoped service. So now we'll need to register as a login form event our login greeting class. And that's it. Now when we open the application, we should be able to see this event being fired. During login, we should be able to see a success notification with our name. Because one thing I didn't emphasize is that we are actually supplying the username to the success message here, the username coming from the context of the event. So the parameters you have for these event methods is always the context of the event, and it depends on the developer who implemented that event, what they expose as the context. Handlers have a pretty big context, of course. Here is login form event is a bit simpler. In any case, well, we are already logged in. So let's log out and let's log in again. All right, we will of course use admin password still. I mean, we will use admin password. And we have our hi admin notification here. So this was just a simple example of an Orchard Core event handler. But again, do note that there are a lot of similar event handlers. So don't be confused if you see something like this. The idea is, the big idea is that you implement an interface, register your implementation, and then automatically the service or the feature exposing that event will call into your implementation too.